This is Storsjon. This vast lake is 8 times the size of Manhattan, big enough to hide its own mythical lake monster, a distant cousin of Nessie. To cross, drivers usually take a ferry. But for 6 months of the year, the temperatures are sub-zero. Which means roads manager Kjell Eriksson is a busy man.
In the summertime, we have the ferries, but wintertime, the ice gets too thick. So, wintertime, we start making the ice roads.
So, how do they do it? The first problem they face is the ice itself. To support a crew and their snowmobile, it must be a minimum of 10 centimeters thick. So they drill at regular intervals to measure the depth of the ice. The next challenge is to strengthen any weak areas. And to do that, they need to freeze fresh layers of water. A powerful pump is dropped into the hole, and seconds later, they have a lake full of liquid H2O on tap. Leveling out the ice across the lake can take several days, but until it's consistently above 17 centimeters, it's not thick enough for the next stage. Snow clearing. The team has 3 roads to plow, and once the snow is clear, each has to pass a series of checks before it can open.
We have to measure the thickness of the ice before we open the ice road, and it should be a minimum 25 centimeters before we can open.
After 2 days' work, it's crunch time. Is the road ready?
It's looking better than 25, so today we can open.
Remarkably, ice not much deeper than the average bath supports around 2,000 cars a day.